Hi guys, thank you so much for tuning in and welcome back to my channel. So not only is this a how-to video, you guys, but I genuinely wanted to show you what happens when life gives you lemons, okay? You get back in there and you create lemonade. So as I was setting up, you guys, to record this video to show you all how to achieve the bohemian straight back look on a child, my tripod decides to snap in half. Okay, so of course I panic, and me being the crazy person that I am, I just didn't know what to do. And I know I really wanted to, you know, showcase this look for you guys, and I just didn't understand what else to do. So you guys, I decided to use a weird, like, you had to be there to actually see what I had to do to record this video. So I had to place my phone at a weird angle, and every time I was turning, I was knocking it over like that. Everything just wasn't making sense at all, but I finally was able to get it for you guys. And as you can see, the angle is a little off and weird, but I couldn't wait to tell you guys this story, and I couldn't wait to tell people out there that genuinely want to record and just don't have the proper tools to do so. You can work with literally anything that's around you, so don't let nothing stop you from recording. If that's truly what you want to do, figure it out. You will get it, just like how I had to figure this out. So yes, you guys, get to recording. So that's my little dilemma for the day. And so yes, you guys, let's get back to this video. And all I'm doing right now is doing the original feed-in method on her hair. And I'm just going to add little pieces of hair as I go. And once we get to the back, I am going to start to add the little curly bohemian beach curl. Whatever curl pattern you decide to use, you're welcome to do so. But for her, I am using the Free Tress bohemian curls. Once you start to add the curls, you're going to leave one strand out, continue to braid, and then take the other strand out of there. And you're going to add as much of the curly hair in there as you like. But for her, because she is a child, I'm only going to add about two little curls for each braid, because you don't want the curls to overtake the style. So therefore, I'm only adding a little bit of curly hair. And the braid should look like this, you guys. And again, you can add as much or as little curls as you like. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button, you guys. Since we are doing cornrows and she's getting about six braids, and all it is, you guys, is just the same repeated steps for each one of the braids. So it's relatively easy. Whatever you did for the first braid, just make sure you do it for the rest. And you can also achieve this look, you guys, with four braids. You don't necessarily need to have 6 braids. I've seen this done in with 5 braids, 4 braids, 6 braids, 8 braids. You just have to make sure whatever the amount of braids you decide, you know, not to overdo the curly hair, because like I said before, you don't want the curls to overpower the look. And sometimes what I've noticed is depending on the curling pattern that you use, that hair can get super matted and super frizzy. So if you go ahead and you overdo the curls, and if it's one of those hair that gets super matted, there's a great chance you're gonna wanna take them out because they're gonna make the style look kinda old if the hair starts to get matted up. Thank you guys so much for sticking with me for this long with my crazy angle. And this is the look, you guys. I'm so excited. Thank you so much for watching. And don't forget, you guys, whatever the obstacle is, you can get over that, okay? Get over that hump. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell button. Peace and love.